I'm going to use this mega favorite number challenge to talk about an intrinsic limitation of numbers on computers. So first of all, my mega favorite number would be 9 quadrillion, 7 trillion, 199 billion, 254 million, 740,993. And this happens to be the smallest natural number that cannot be stored in the standard double precision format on a computer. So what does double mean and why do I care so much about it? So double is one of the available formats using which we can store numbers on a computer. And there are many other formats, for example, integers available. And I particularly care about double because it is the most commonly used format when we use computing in science and engineering. So computers usually store numbers in its binary representation. So here is a small table which shows the conversion of a few decimal numbers in and its binary representation. So the takeaway from here is that for every power of 2 that we add, we need one more bit or one more digit in its binary representation. So 2, which is just 2 power 1, is 1 followed by just 1 0. 8, which is 2 power 3, is 1 followed by 3 zeros. And 32, which is 2 power 5, is 1 followed by 5 zeros. So the standard format for double precision is called binary 64 by IEEE. And in this format, there are 64 bits which are used to represent numbers. So since we are dealing with floating point numbers, the numbers are first converted to this form of m into 2 power n, where m is called the significand and n is the exponent. So out of these 64 bits that we have, one bit is allotted to store the sign of m. The next 11 bits store the value of n, including its sign. And the last 52 bits store the value of m. So the question is, what happens when m cannot be stored in 52 bits? We just saw from the conversion table earlier that this is about bound to happen around a certain power of 2, and this power of 2 happens to be 2 power 53. So let's explore the neighborhood of 2 power 53. So here is a small Python loop which prints out whether a number in its integer form is the same as the number represented in double. So in Python, we do this by calling this function float. So I'm printing out the neighborhood of 2 power 53. And nothing happens unexpectedly until we go till 2 power 53. But this big number here is no longer the same as its floating point version, which is stored as double. So what is happening? So the number which I mentioned earlier is nothing but 2 power 53 plus 1. So when I write it as m into 2 power n, the significand becomes 1 followed by 52 zeros and another 1 at the end. But since we only have 52 slots to store these bits, the last digit, which is 1, cannot be stored. And this is the reason the float of this big number becomes its previous number itself. So what is the takeaway here? Well, no matter which format which we choose to store our numbers in a computer, we are definitely going to have to deal with finite precision because we cannot keep storing different digits of a number. But a good thing is that numbers, especially in a format like double, are well represented for most practical purposes. And we usually at least have a decent approximation of the number which we want to store. And of course, for those of you who are interested, there is also something called symbolic computing, which turns the idea of storing numbers on its head and says that we no longer care about numbers being stored as numbers, but instead we start looking at them as symbols, and therefore, in principle, we can have infinite precision. So that's something to check out if you're interested. Finally, I would end with some food for thought for you. So here I'm asking Python to print out whether it thinks 0.1 plus 0.1 plus 0.1 is the same as 0.3. And Python tells me it's false. So if I print out the left-hand side and the right-hand side, I can see that, yes, indeed, the left-hand side is not 0.3, but it is in something else slightly different. So can you figure out why and how finite precision can explain this behavior, let me know in the comments, and thanks for watching.